Today we're giving a full review of the Jetboil Genesis Camp Stove. We're going to cover how to set it up, how to tear it down, how to use it, what we like and what we don't like about it. Let's get started. Hey there, I'm Will, and thank you for joining Venture to Rome today. We're a channel that goes on incredible adventures, finding ways to connect to nature, get out of the barrage of everyday life, and celebrate the beautiful public lands around us. Okay, Jetboil Genesis. First, let's take a look at how we store it. We keep the stove stored neatly away in one of our DeWalt boxes, which we really love because of how compact and useful they are. The Jetboil fits perfectly inside this box. Let's take it out. As you can see, it comes with a carrying bag, propane hookup, and a windscreen. Setting it up is super easy. Just undo the straps, unfold it, connect the propane, and voila. Compared to other stoves, the Jetboil doesn't really set up any faster or slower, but what's nice about it is the components are all made really, really well. So I have confidence that when we're using this thing, these little connection pieces aren't gonna break prematurely, which is just a nice peace of mind to have. Now, this stove was not a small investment for us, and one of the major reasons that we decided to make the investment is because of the shape. So this shape, the way it's designed, allows us to get two full-size pans or pots cooking at the same time versus our other camp stoves, which only allowed one, and sometimes even if the pan was big, you couldn't get the whole pan on there, so the burner would kind of be off center. And that is one of the best features of the Jetboil Genesis. You can get two things cooking at the same time. You can get a cast iron grill on there sometimes. It's really wide and it fits on there perfect. So that's one of the major benefits of having this stove. Okay, let's talk functionality. This is where the rubber meets the road for us. So how does this thing actually cook food? So the first thing to mention is the ignition switch. It's a pull lever instead of a push button. And that pull lever is easy to flick. You just kind of flick it and it works almost every time. So I've never had a problem starting the stove. It's just like one or two flicks of that thing and it starts up. So that's good. Now, other than the physical design of this stove, what really sets it apart from the pack is its flame regulators. Here's where it's really different. Those knobs, you have to turn many rotations to get to go to high or low. And that's because the flame regulation is very, very accurate and tied to these knobs. So you can tweak the heat. You can get it just to a simmer. You can cook things on low. Our other camp stoves, it was kind of like cold or scorched. In fact, I remember one time I was out with the guys and we were cooking bratwursts for lunch. And so this is like a glorified hot dog. And I remember scorching the pan. It was too cold to cook on low, and so I had to heat the thing up, and by heating the thing up, I just scorched it. So I just talked about some of the things that we love about this stove. Now let me mention some of the things that I do not love. So I know I just said I love the knobs and the flame regulator, but I also do not like the knobs. And it's because you have to turn them so many times to get to maximum or back to minimum that it's hard to track where you are. So it takes a lot of practicing getting used to and kind of feel for where you are between minimum and maximum. And I think if they had just put like a red dot at the end of one, it would be easier to track. So that's a little bit of a gripe that I have about the knobs. So the next thing that I do not like about the Jetboil is the price. I mean, come on, Jetboil. Why does it have to be so expensive? I mean, it's not even close. Our first stove was like 25 bucks. This thing was like, I don't even remember. It was like 280, it was $300. I mean, it was so expensive for a stove. Now, it's a great stove, but does it have to be so expensive? Okay, so the last thing that I have a gripe about is the windscreen. The windscreen on the Jetboil does not match the rest of it. The rest of it is so well built. There's this flimsy, little, hard to connect, plastic windscreen that doesn't do a very good job, is really hard to get right. So I have never been able to actually put it on there correctly and get it to stay in place. The few times I've tried it, it hasn't done a very good job of blocking the winds, and it just seems like a miss to me. Now I know it's a trade-off because the design of the Jetboil itself is rounded, which makes it hard to make a windscreen for it, so I get that. But for some people, it might be a big trade-off. For us, not so much because we have the tailgate table on the Jeep, which does a great job at blocking wind. But if we didn't have that, that could be a pretty big problem whenever it's windy and you want to make dinner or breakfast or whatever. Putting it away is just as easy as setting it up. You just disconnect your propane attachments, fold it up, put the leather straps where they go, put it back in the bag, and stow it wherever you want. Kate and I tend to skew more towards foodie when we're cooking in the backcountry. So for us, the Jetboil Genesis was a great investment. The shape, allowing us to get pots and pans on there that are the right size, the flame regulation, the compactness of it that allows us to stow it away in our Jeep really easily, just make it a really great addition to our kitchen for us. There are definite trade-offs and drawbacks, and it's expensive, so I wouldn't necessarily recommend it for everybody. But if you're somebody who really likes to take your cooking seriously, or at least try hard, this could be a really great addition to your setup. If there's something that we didn't cover that you want to talk about, drop it in the comment section and we can start our conversation there. Also, if you're looking for more recommendations on kitchen gear, I did a great video with four other Overland YouTube channels where we all kind of listed our recommendation for kitchen gear. It's fantastic, you should check it out. It's on the screen right now. If you found this video helpful, please hit the like button. And if you want to see more content from us, please hit the subscribe button. It really helps the channel and we value every single subscriber. So thank you to those who have subscribed. Thank you in advance to those who will subscribe. And until next time, I'm Will from Venture to Rome. We'll see you later.